Morning everyone. I just thought I'd record a quick clip just to show you and tease you, if you're in the cold right now, how lovely and gorgeously sunny it is today in Cyprus. I've just dropped the little boy off to nursery and the hound is just on a walk eating some grass today, and I'm going to be recording my episode 11, I think we're on now, literally in about a couple of hours time after I've done my little morning routine. So yeah, speak to you in a second, I suppose. Hello everyone, happy new year! Welcome to episode 11 of the Lorraine Pugh Designs video series, all based on yarny goodness, mostly crochet, but recently I've been doing a fair bit of knitting as well. Anything that you see in this video, you'll be able to see, you'll be able to find the information for underneath the video, also on my blog. I put the show notes on there, and that's lorrainepughdesigns.blogspot.com. On Instagram, I am Lorraine Pugh Designs. On Ravelry as well, the show notes are there in the Lorraine Pugh Designs group. I'm on Ravelry as Lorraine Pugh. I've got a couple of Facebook pages as well. Well, one Facebook page called Lorraine Pugh Designs, and then a group called Lorraine Pugh Designs Project Bag, which is where you can share any works in progress that you're doing. So with all that contact stuff out the way, how are you all? I'm doing very well. The beginning of this year has been a bit of a shifting for me, with different paths that I'm taking. At the end of last year, I stopped working in my mum's shop. We then went for a 2-week holiday to the UK over Christmas and New Year. And so coming back to Cyprus, which is where this is being recorded right now, my home, I'm still sort of transitioning. I'm going through my cupboards basically, and because I only live in a two-bedroom first floor apartment with my husband, who actually works in Africa. We have a son who's nearly 3 now, and so we haven't really got any spare rooms or anything, so any stock that was left over from my mum's shop that I will be keeping for my mum and myself, and for some workshops perhaps as well that I might run from home. I'm having to be quite creative with where I store everything, so I don't want to rush that either. Because if I rush a job, I don't do it properly. So I'm being quite methodical with that. And I don't like to do that when my son's around. So yeah, I've been doing that. Sort of nearly getting there, but I don't know. I'm quite easily overwhelmed with stuff like that. So I still wanna do more than I think I physically can. But there we go. Something, talking about that sort of stuff, something I got in the UK which I found to be really good is this book. It's Breathe Journal 50-week planner, and it's really good if you're not so great with maintaining a diary all the time and you want to sort of be a bit more organized. A book like this is really good because it's not dated, you actually write the dates in yourself, and it's got like a 7-day plan, that sort of stuff. And then it's also got this reflection page, and so that is really good. And this is the sort of thing that would be quite good for me, because I'm not as much as I hate to admit it, I'm not very good at being organised with things that I'm not necessarily passionate about. So things, you know, the more mundane stuff will be in here, as well as the odd thing to do with crochet and whatever. Another thing I'm starting, and I'm also including this on, or ideas like this on my blog, started a positivity board. Now, I used to use this when my son was a baby. Nice little quotes and stuff if I was ever feeling knackered or whatever. But then we used it in my mum's shop. You can see where it's been used for business cards, stuff like that. And now I've reclaimed it and I've written on there, this year I will. And I'm starting to gather some positive imagery and yarns, works in progress, projects, all things that I want to keep on here and things that inspire me as well. I'm going to be doing, filling this board up with lovely things. What I've also been doing, I've been drinking this pucker tea, Christmas tea. Oh, it's lovely. Quite spicy. And with the tabs, I've been keeping them and pegging them on the top, so it's a little bit like bunting, and using these little pegs. I just thought that was really, really cute, so I thought I'd share that with you. But I'm really excited to say that I've been doing a little bit of research because I'm quite interested in things like psychology and things, and I'm no expert by any stretch of the imagination, but I've figured out more about myself from doing these things and applying it to like my crafting side, like the crochet and the knitting, and it's been really, really fun because I know what I'm not very good at, and it sort of made me realise why I'm not good at them, and therefore finding ways of how to be better at them. And so I've compiled loads and loads of facts and ideas and things like that, and I've been putting them, all writing them up on my laptop, in my journal if I haven't got the laptop to hand, and I'm going to create a series of blog posts, and they will be titled under sort of the umbrella name of Creative Contentment, and on Instagram I'll be using the hashtag Creative Contentment as well. I've done one blog post so far about making resolutions, so you can check that out. It's only a short and sweet one. But when I was thinking of these ideas of doing this, I was doing a bit of Googling here and there, and I was trying to think, what can I call it? Before I came up with Creative Contentment, it was just an idea and I had other names. But I knew I wanted to have an Instagram hashtag, and I thought I'm a big believer in you know, having little signs that point you in the right direction and just going with the flow and things like that. And I will briefly say as well, for a lovely Christmas present, a lovely Ali from Starry Eyes, well, she's Starry Eyes on Instagram, sorry, but she's from the Little Drops of Wonderful podcast. She kindly gave me a box of so many lovely, lovely presents. I've shared a picture on Instagram anyway. I wouldn't know where to begin if I were to show you those bit by bit. One of the things she did share though, and she did give me, she gave me two of these, and these are origami hearts, and I thought, oh, that's so cute. So I've pegged this one on my calendar, but I've got it here to show it to you. And I thought that was so sweet. And anyway, when I was doing this bit of research for figuring out what I was going to call the blog posts, I typed in the hashtag Creative Contentment, and there are about 5 or 6 images, I think, I can't remember now, but only a few, literally just to fill the screen. And one of the images was a pink origami heart. That was all it was, just a big pink origami heart. And I thought, oh, that's weird, because I'd never seen these before. And this was literally like the day after I opened the box and found that. And so for that reason, I thought, right, I've got to call it Creative Contentment then. And then literally again the next day when I was doing some research, and there were a couple of things I needed to just look up. So I went on Google, typed in the words I needed to, and the top thing that came up, and there's this article with this origami heart. And I just thought, for me personally, I do believe that things like that, you should really go with those, and they are just sort of little hints to show you that you're going in the right direction. So that's the direction I'm going in this year. And I know things change and things progress and we're all learning. So if we could do that together, and if you could just read the blog post and see what you think of them, and I'd love your input, that would be brilliant, because I think we can better each other as well as ourselves, can't we? Okay, so without further ado, I'll also start showing you some acquisitions of things that I got, one in the UK. One of them, it's a gorgeous, cute little thing, while we were shopping in Wales, in the town centre, was this gorgeous little market stall, this girl who'd handmade all these like ceramic things, and I couldn't resist this sheep, and he's speckled like hand-dyed yarns as well, and I just thought, he's so cute. So he is going to be a little friend to Chicken that sometimes makes an appearance in some of my pictures. And that lovely sheep is made by this girl, Sian Davies. So I'll just hold that there so you can pause it if you want to have a look at any of her information. But I'll also put a link below. So I got that. I also went, I'm so excited about this, went to Yak Yarn Shop, Yarn and Knitting in Brighton. I've got their business card here. I was so excited to go in there. Now, I'll show you the yarn in a minute, but I got a couple of, because Lisa of Lisa Pine Notes on YouTube and on Instagram, she has inspired me to try and focus on some Tunisian crochet at some stage. So I like natural material, so I went for a bamboo hook, bamboo Tunisian crochet hook, and I've gone for, what size is that one? 5mm and 4mm, because I'll see how I get on. I don't think these unscrew, I'll have to look anyway, I'm pretty sure they don't. But it would be good if I could get some that did unscrew. But anyway, that's to make a start on those and see how I get on. What else did I get? I got... Oh, let's just have a quick sniff of this. Yeah, lovely. Soak. Because I haven't got anything to wash my yarny good things in. And that does smell lovely. So I thought I would give that a go. I'll let you know how I get on with that. Okay, I will show you the yarns now. Right, first of all, I'll show you this one. I've got to be careful because this is attached to a project I'm about to show you. But look how gorgeous this is. That's a lie. This is a lie. I'm showing you something. This I didn't get from the yarn store. Let me... that's a lie. I got a bit confused there. Forget what I said. Erase your memory from the last 30 seconds or so. Right, start again. No, didn't get that from there. What I did get from there is this green, mossy green. It's going to be a bit of glare today, but can you see that? That's quite a good representation. This is BFL Fingering by The Uncommon Thread. And I was intending to put this with something else that I got in... Yak. I'm just going to put it with this one, which is a gorgeous coral colour, as you can probably see, by Life in the Long Grass. I'm going to pair these together with also a colour that really ties them together. Another yarn by The Uncommon Thread, BFL Fingering. This one. And this one is called, just trying to get you to see that. There we go, I just should hold it there. This one is called Peat. This one, I can't remember what this one is. It doesn't actually, oh, here it is, Zitouni. Peat, Zitouni, and then this one by Life in the Long Grass is called Perfume. And I thought about doing a thin stripe knitted shawl or something, or maybe crochet. But as what often happens with me, I get an idea, I take action, and then later on my ideas sort of twist and I get inspired by other people. So what actually happened is I didn't, because I used these for one of my works in progress, which I'll show you in a moment. So those I got from Yak, and I also got from Yak well, my son and my husband were in at the time, and I want to make my son a scarf. And so I said to him that you can pick your own. And straight away, he went for this. Not what I would pick, obviously. Not necessarily, obviously, but he just loved it. Really super chunky, single ply, wool and the gang, cloudy blue. And this really would suit him really well. He's kind of like warm spring, I think it's called. He's got like warm, he's blonde, blue-eyed, but with sort of yellow-toned skin, I suppose. So this will suit him really, really well. And I just can't wait to make a fur. I thought it was so cute when he picked that out, like the first time that he's ever picked yarn out for himself that's in a shop that wasn't, you know, my mum's shop or anything. It was just a really, really fun experience. Really good time down in Brighton. That's that one. Something else. So that was what I got in Yak. Something else, well, another place I went to in Brighton, was this, Brighton Sewing Centre. Really cute little shop. The lady in there was so lovely. I got some buttons in there. Three of each of these, which are actually going to be a gift. Tiny cute little buttons. Can you see those? And then these, which I thought looked like, was probably supposed to look like a ball of yarn. They're like metal buttons, and I thought they would look really nice on something. So I've got a few of those for myself. I think I'm just going to show you my work in progress now, which I'm really, really excited about. A few minutes ago, I showed you this. This yarn is gorgeous to work with. Have you heard the latest craze? There's a knitting cowl going on called Find Your Fade Cowl. And this is it so far. It will be a shawl. If you can see that. So I'll show you that, and then I'll show you what it will be. It's here. This is designed by Andrea, Mowry of Drea, Renee Knits for the love. It's that, the Find Your Fade Shawl. So you work from this corner, and you increase in the middle, and you don't increase in the middle, you increase on the outside, sorry, decrease in the middle. And eventually you stop decreasing on one side and then just work, it sort of pans across. And when I first saw it, it was actually via Amber of the Yarn Junkie podcast. She'd shared a picture of these lovely yarns. And I thought, oh, they look really good together. And she said about the Find Your Fade cowl. And so I clicked on that, saw all these other pictures on Instagram of people sharing all these different yarn skeins put together. And I thought, what's this all about? So I did a bit of research from clicking on the hashtags and whatever, and I think you should really check it out. I'm currently changing colour, which I'll try to show you, but my knitting has come on leaps and bounds thanks to this knit along. I mean, I'm so proud of that lace work. The other side is a lot looser with the lace, I think, because it's one side slip knit and the other's knit two together, so that side is looser than that side, but I'm really not fussed about that. But the colour change, can you see? I'm just starting to change colour. And I'll show you that ball of yarn in a minute. But this one is called Forest, and it's been amazing to work with. I love it. It's the first yarn I've ever bought from the company Blueberry Barn Yarn. Which, all the cards are in here. So I'll just get this. Sorry, Blueberry Barn Designs. And honestly, it's just amazing to work with. It's beautiful. I even took a picture the other day of the conifer plants outside, because she's really, or whoever's dyed this, I don't actually know the name of the person. So when I say she, I could be jumping to conclusions. But there are emerald greens, mossy greens, tealy greens, really dark greens, just beautiful. Forest really does hit the nail on the head with that name. And on this work in progress, I'll show you what I'm doing. I'm using lovely Ali, again from Little Drops of Wonderful podcast. She gave me these in the packet of Christmassy goodness, so a little bit of magic, and that's the stitch marker I'm using, so I know where the centre is. And I've also put these on. These were originally stitch markers from Crafty Cat Knitty Bits, those top bits, but I've added some fake flowers to them to remind me, two different flowers, to remind me which is the right side and which is, you know, the wrong side. I think I figured it out now by looking at the spine, but being not very good at knitting or not being so familiar with it, I needed a visual reference. So the colour, oh, by the way, my Find Your Fade shawl I'm going to do in six colours. And so this is the next colour that I got. And this is called Attention Seeker, Superwash Merino by Hand Dyed by Kate. Some gorgeous colours in there. And I thought it would transition quite nicely from that to that. And then the next one I'll show you, which you've already seen, is actually this one. That's by Life in the Long Grass, called Perfume. That's that, 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 and that. Let me just sneak that one down there. In there. The next yarn I'm going to do, so from this to this one, and this is called Sweet Treat by Artist Palette Yarns. So far we've got that, 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 and that. And then next, I saw this on Ali's podcast, A Little Drops of Wonderful, again. I saw this on her video, and I'd been looking at this online, and I love it. This is called Mazikeen. Can you see all the different colours in there? There's sort of such muted, it's like a beige taupe, whatever you would call that, taupe, with sort of really muted purple, and even the occasional bit of, my eyes are telling me it's green, but it could even be this lightest amount of black on beige, which is making it look green just along there. I'll show you the cards for these. So we've got Sweet Treat by Artist Palette Yarns, the logo there. It's always good to see the logo. And this Mazikeen is by Third Vault Yarns. And then the last one is one that I've shown you before, Peat by The Uncommon Thread. So those will meld, hopefully. You'll be able to see. There we go. So I'm starting in this colour, then gradually change colour. And I'm just really excited about this cowl. There are so many other things I should be finishing, but I just saw it and you know when you get that like sick excited feeling. I don't know if you get that, but I do. And I couldn't resist it. I thought, why should I resist it? No, I want to do it. Plus, also, with this year, I've thought, no, it's really good to get a balance of sort of work and play. And even though it's not necessarily making money, I do feel like in the day when I'm working, when I'm putting away, I'm organising all the home. So by the time I come to the evening, although I should probably keep organising, part of me thinks, no, just chill out. Just chill, Loza, just chill. Sorry, Loza, Lorraine. Some of my friends call me Loza. I forgot to mention that sometimes. So this is what I'm doing. Some people say it looks like a thong. But what do you reckon? Bearded lady. So yeah, I'm just so excited about that. And I've looked at a couple of YouTube videos at how to hold your yarn when knitting. And I finally mastered it, holding it in the right hand, because being a crocheter I tend to hold it in my left, but I've actually mastered knitting with my right hand, and it's, I'm just really proud of that, because I do dream one day of being able to do colour work where I'm holding the yarn in both hands and knitting, you know, using the two different yarns. So I figured that if I could learn to hold the yarn with my right hand, that would be really beneficial for perhaps one day being able to tick colour work off the list. So other things that I'm working on, I've shown you before, this beautiful, beautiful design This one, Hotel of Bees by Christina Haddowing, also known as A Spoonful of Yarn. I'll show you this briefly because I've shown it to you before a few times, keep mentioning it. But yeah, look how this, how nicely this is coming along. I'm really, really proud of that. Look at that honeycomb. The colours are just beautiful together. If I twist it, you just get a good idea of how the colours are playing with each other. There are two browns in there. They're quite similar, but just how I wanted them, with the sort of a golden honey colour. And I've got the cards here just to show you again, just so you know. These are by Die for Yarn, and this one's Too Hard Butter Cookie. Then we have dropping things left, right and centre here. Then we have Boiling Cacao, the darker brown. And then the middle brown is Burnt Cinnamon Roll. There we go. So they're my two projects that I'm working on at the minute. The crochet one I can really relax with. So like if my little boy has fallen asleep, I can sort of just sit and work on that without thinking about it too much. Whereas the knitting one, I do feel that I need to do that when I've got complete concentration. So I'll probably, after recording this, I'll probably get back to work on that if I can resist the laptop. So I really want to get this these blog posts written up. I'll go a little boring and tell you a little bit more about those. I've in the past mentioned about me taking that online personality test, and just for fun initially, but again, like I mentioned earlier, I learned so much about myself. And so I was looking at all the other outcomes and ways to improve things and how our minds work and all of this. And so what I've actually done, I'm halfway through creating an online quiz where you'll be able to figure out what sort of a crafter you are. And it is based on yarn, the yarn craft, if you like, so knitting, crochet. And it'll all be under the Creative Contentment hashtag on Instagram. So I'm just typing up the what will be the results. There'll be 16 different outcomes, I'll let you all know when I've finally done it, because I need to really create a big image as well to for the actual quiz itself. And I'm really, really excited about that. All these exciting things happening. And I'm really, really excited to be getting back into recording these videos after the holidays now. So there were a couple of opportunities. I probably could have recorded one or two a couple of weeks ago, but it would have been under pressure. And I don't believe in that too much. So lovely to chat with you all again. And I will see you in a couple of weeks. Keep in touch via Instagram and Ravelry. Let me know what you think about these blog post ideas. And if there are any things that you have struggles with or problems with, please share them and we can perhaps work through them together. And all the things you find that, you know, if you've got any successful habits or tips that really work for you, then that would be great. Certain little things like keeping a little journal of your progress. I've got about 7 blog posts that are all in my mind that I keep adding to here and there. And like some of us tend to be procrastinators, don't we? And some of us tend to have too many WIPs and all of things like that. So I'll be focusing on those and how we can maybe improve. Again, I'm not an expert, it'll be more for fun. I'm learning all the time. I love to learn from you guys. You help me. We all help each other, I think. So any input as far as that is concerned would be really, really good. I think I'm going to leave it there now and save any other bits I've got to show you probably for a couple of weeks' time. I'm going to try and limit this to about half an hour, and I've got a snippet to add. So take care, everybody. Lovely to chat with you all again, and looking forward to speaking to you via Instagram, Ravelry, all the other things. Thank you for watching. Take care, everyone. Bye.